Star Wars fans, this is Fly Guy with another Star Wars toy and figure collectible review. This is another older figure from the Vinci's collection, which I'm just filling in the gaps of the waves that I never collected, but the figure that I omitted the first time round. So this is the Phantom Menace Gungan Warrior. Actually not a bad figure, really, all in. I'm not a Gungan fan, as many of you all know, but I wanted that complete collection. Had to get them all. So Gungan Warrior card, nicely done the Phantom Menace logo display there on this vintage style card. You can see the figure in the bubble, and the image on the card back is the, I cannot remember the name of those alien creatures, Kladu or something like that. Anyway, pretty decent looking card actually, not bad at all. And on the back we get a little snapshot of the first time the figure's been in a card, which is never really. And a little bit of a scenario of the, well, it probably was in the Phantom Menace, I guess, but a little snapshot of the figure's background on the card. 1989 was the first time it came out. There's the rest of the figures, all of which were reviewed on our channel. Check them out. And that is it. Let's go look at the figure. Comes with a couple of strange accessories. I'll leave that to the a little bit later on. Let's show you the figure. Now, the stand is my own. Let's zoom in and get a look at this figure overall. Super close up, there we go. So he comes with a fair decent job on the paint. You'll see the kind of gold and the brown there on the belt and the torso, and the green of his kind of body is well done. It's well painted on, the detail in his eyes, it's well painted. That's one positive comment I can give the figure itself. Even down to the toes, he's got some detail rocking on. Even down to little toenails there, and a little bit of paint work done around the toes themselves, like bones or claws, I think, whatever you want to call them. On the back of the figure, there's a little bit of a silvery wash that's been put across the figure too. Just gives it a little bit of finish, sort of weathered look. So it's again, there's been some love done by Hasbro on this figure. All the detail, that kind of gold gilt around the back. And big floppy ears on there too. So it's well crafted, well molded, just not a Gungan fan. Now this, his staff is super long. You can see the size of this thing there if I hold that back out. If I just give you a better close up of it, comes in two parts. There we go. So a little bit of detail at the top where I guess the blue ball should be. God, this is turning into a review of innuendos, but there's no blue ball. So there's no blue ball on his shaft. Oh dear. So I'm not quite sure what's going on there. Maybe that was a pack in they thought at one point, but there's nothing. There's no peg hole in there for that to be clipped in, but it looks as if it's missing because it is on the front of the card. You can just see on the front of the card there underneath the name, he's got that kind of blue piece there. So the two pieces clip together and form that there. So again, well done by Hasbro. Silver colour. The brown piece on the shaft and the gold at the gilt at the end. So it looks the part. Comes with one other accessory, which is, believe it or not, the most ridiculous looking binoculars. Yes, Gungans need even silly binoculars to be using them. So those two little dots up there, it looks like are basically where you would look through. And this pocket-sized set of binoculars, you then carry around on top of your chest. Talk about portable, geez. It has a little, each ball at the end. Oh my God, this is just some review. There's a little ball on each which rotates round. The Gungan's balls rotate and are blue. Oh my God. There's a kind of beautiful detail, actually. It's like a kind of underwater algae that's been applied there. A kind of green effect here and there across it, which is very detailed and very nice for something that's ultimately rubbish. A lot of details went into this. You can see it on all the little notches and joins there. And the idea is that, and correct me if I'm wrong, if you know better about Gungan, then I'll be happily filled in. But portable Gungan takes it out of his pocket and puts on it over his shoulders and is then able to, and if I can line this up properly, there you go. You basically, he looks through with these big beady eyes and looks even more crazy and mental. Is that right? That's what it seems to be, but I may be wrong. So he then has to kind of hold these on to walk around with them, but it looks so bizarre. So I've taken them off. not much really else to say about this guy. Again, I wanted to collect all the figures from the Weave, and it is well made, so it is a good job it has. Well, very good price at Dark Side Toys. I can't remember the exact price. I'll put the link directly underneath. But they've plenty of Star Wars figures on there, so check them out. These things tend to go, actually, sometimes can go a little bit nuts in the second-hand market at times. So if you're looking for some vintage figures or older Star Wars figures, check them out on their site and fill in the gaps. But look, again, plenty of detail. Let's just jump to articulation. He's got an articulated, stocky head, you can see up there. So plenty of movement and maneuverability in there. So again, it does look the part. He's got a ball joint with a hinge at the shoulders, ball joint with a hinge at the elbows, and he has a swivel gauntlets or gloves, whatever you want to call it. He does have a swivel torso, and you can see he's got swivel hips. You can also see his ball jointed knees, particularly at the back. Ball joint with a hinge there, and the ball joint with a hinge at the ankles. And obviously he's got a peg hole, and the stand is my own. So that is your Gungan Warrior. Not the best figure in the world, but he's not a Padme, so it's a whole lot cooler for me. And I have to give a kudos to Hasbro for this absolutely bizarre piece here. Well, George Lucas really, he designed the thing, I guess, or Doug Chang, but ultimately silly, but would love to know, is there any other uses for this, or am I doing it wrong? But it looks to me like a giant set of binoculars. What are your thoughts? Talk about the binoculars, even talk about these blue balls, whatever turns you on. Leave a comment below, and you can also join us, as usual, I'm sure you know, on Twitter as @FlyGuy, on Facebook as FlyGuy.net, and we're also on Google Plus as +FlyGuy. That's it for this figure. We'll see you for another Star Wars figure review coming up soon. Cheers!